Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Grimwit, and this is Miasmata. The best way to explain this game is that it is an exploration adventure, with emphasis on exploration. This game is very chill, and I'd really like to show it to you. I think you will find it relaxing, mysterious, and at times silly. Let's begin. Awake and shipwrecked. Good. I have all of my fingers, at least on my left hand. And we begin. That must have been our ship. Obviously. Robert Hughes is not a good shipsman. I'm not entirely certain how he got this ship to back up onto the shore. The controls are very simple. Wads to move. Control to crouch. Left click to create rocks. Press and hold the left click to throw the rock, and then watch the engine break. The game engine is customized by the brothers Johnson. It is called the Milo engine, and as you can tell, it is perfect in every way. We can't drink the seawater. Shift to run, and as you can see from our tutorial, tab to open our journal. Get out of here, tutorial. I'll explain this. The journal is our status and our notes. Right now, our notes are empty. Let's see what happened to our fellow researchers. Robert Hughes walks in a strange way. He moves with the momentum of a marble. As well as being a medical researcher, he is apparently a marble. Some of the details in this game is amazing. Ah. All notes I get, I will put into the Something Awful thread. For everyone else, you can pause. Ketchup. Lots of ketchup. This man died of a ketchup overdose. Let's take his knife. The combat mechanics of this game are limited. I'm pretty sure that hit, but it didn't do anything because you cannot actually hurt any animals in this game. Another important mechanic is the medicine mechanic. Here we have our bin. It's a very strange inventory system, which I will cover later. Here's where we do our research and instructions on how. It's very simple. Put the specimen in the examination tray and click on the microscope. Here's the synthesis. Hello. That is worrying. Here's the synthesis table. We can combine plants and make medicines. Here's how we save. These many bottles of chemicals are decorative. I wonder where they kept all of their equipment and their chemicals. You'd think there'd be a very large ship around here, but I haven't seen one. Every time you find a new flower, plant, or fungus, it will create a new entry in your journal, but it won't tell you its research. These two plants are a good tutorial plant to set to have. Sorry, I tripped over my words there. It's because these plants create the most basic and most important items. We also need to drink. The plague we have causes us to dehydrate. It also allows us, for whatever reason, to create fire from nothing without flint or tinder. Pyrokinesis is one of the symptoms, I suppose. Let's try the white flower first, but before that, I need another one. It will make sense in a second. When we begin, we have no knowledge of what these plants do. But after some research, we can find that this plant makes some basic medicine. Let's make some basic medicine. In the future, I will probably be skipping these scenes. But this episode might as well show you all the animations. We have created basic medicine. Whenever we become dizzy from fever, this will lower our fever and stabilize the vision of the screen. Now that we have research, we can turn to pages in our book and skip quickly to each page. Now, what does this do? extra strength medicine. We can combine this plant with the other flower to create super medicine. Someone once told me that music is how we decorate time. If that's so, I really find the ambient sound of this game to be very musical. Even though there is no actual music. There we are. The extra strength medicine will reduce our fever and dizzy spells, and also it will prevent future dizzy spells, I think, for the rest of the day. In my experience, it is basically just a secondary medicine. Now, why aren't we making pill after pill? Just before lunch. It's because we can only carry one set of each kind of pill with us at a time. When I first began playing this game, I went back and forth thinking that I was creating more and more pills, but in actuality, I was just wasting flowers. You right-click to pull up the watch and the compass, which is what you saw back there. I do that a lot because I get lost easily in this game. I'll try to keep that to a minimum as I play through. Time is important. Sunset, doubly so. Ah, crates. Must be where they kept the chemicals. There are many houses like this around the island, which is good. Create fire, and take a look at this. When we begin, we have no map, just a blank sheet of paper. This is our first map, and from it we could, conceivably, create the entire island. Fortunately, we won't have to do that much work. Just showing off that we can quickly turn to a page. Here we can sleep. I don't think we'll need to. Here is a banana. A deadly weapon. Yes, I am proficient in banana combat. Let's throw it. There is nothing wrong with the engine. The engine is fine. Maybe your physics are broken. Did you ever think about that? With that experiment done, take a look. It's just afternoon. And we'll continue with our journey. Giant head in the window. They are useful, the giant heads. This note basically outlines how we make maps. I will show that off this episode. The mapping mechanic is also important, but not necessary like the medicine mechanic is. Now that we're outside of Camp Draco, we see the world open up in front of us. Unlike other adventure games, this adventure game is very non-linear. You could go anywhere in the island right off the bat. You could simply walk out into the world and explore, make a map. You wouldn't even need to complete the quest. Mushroom. Around here, towards the back of this path, I believe there is another mushroom. This doorway does not lead to it. This leads to the miniature lake, and there's our laboratory in the distance. But I know there is another mushroom around here. There they are. We'll be researching these by the end of the episode. I'm sticking close to the water to keep trees out of my way, because the way that I want to introduce the cartography mechanics, I have a particular distant giant head in mind. And there it is. There's that house and that house. So here's how this works. You pull up your map, you find a location on your map, so that you can draw a line to it from your current location. Or the other way around, from the location to you. That way you can triangulate an exact position on your map. You can then draw a line to distant items. Landmarks, giant heads, buildings. I'm searching for other landmarks, but I don't see any. That's okay. It may rain. Cliffs are dangerous. Ooh, we're getting thirsty. Let's take care of that. We have 5 drinks from our canteen, which refills every time we drink water from things other than the canteen, such as a pitcher or a small pond. As I was saying, cliffs are dangerous, even small cliffs, because Robert Hughes has ankles of glass to pair with his nerves of steel. There we go, we can see the distant head. When we open up our map, it will automatically point out where we are, because we're close enough to an outpost. But as you can see, it's not really giving us the option to add unknown landmarks. So we triangulate again, and then we can add future landmarks. Starting with that distant head, and now we know its true position. We can zoom in on it with the right click, and it will always be there in the map, something that we can reference later on down the line. It's a good idea to get in a position where you can see many things. Here I am cheating a little bit, because I know that there are 2 camps I can see from here, but they're not very noticeable in the distance. I don't believe they've been drawn yet. The draw distance of this game is terrible. But if you hold still long enough, the graphics are gorgeous. And I believe the ambience goes a long way. There's a second head over there, but I don't think I can get to it. Nope. Nope. Okay. Now, what's in here? Bananas. pictures of the research team. Pyrokinesis candle. And another map. This map reaches further on past the swamp. It's a trail we'll follow next episode, but not right now. There's not much more in here. So, let's fast forward just a little bit. What you missed was me searching around the area for a pile of twigs to show off another pyrokinesis trick. Anytime Robert Hughes picks up twigs, it immediately catches fire. But with these twigs, he can pull off another trick. You don't have to save only with candles and lanterns inside buildings. These landmarks allow you to save outside of buildings. And there are many of them all over the island. There's even an achievement for setting fire to all of them. We fast forward again, because on my way back to Outpost Draco, I saw these flowers, and they're very beautiful. So let's head back to the laboratory and do some research. Starting with our gray mushroom. Yay. This creates a mental stimulant, which is good for avoiding danger. We'll make some of that next episode. Here's our red cap mushrooms. This one's good for making mental tonics, which is a map-making helper. It will allow us to see where we are on the map, even if we're not in a place we know. And here's the sunflowers. Near as we can tell, these are useless. That's it for this episode. Thank you for joining me in this game. I hope to have you all with me through the rest of it. I plan on completing the game and showing you where to find all the important plants. Until next time, stay tranquil.